Hello everyone, a warm welcome to 10th class biology session. In this video, we are going to learn about human excretory system. Excretion is a process of sending waste material from the body. The organs which are responsible for the elimination of metabolic waste products are called excretory organs. Waste products like carbon dioxide, water, nitrogenous compounds like ammonia, urea, uric acid, bile pigments and excess salts etc. are produced in human body during different metabolic activities. Some of these may be harmful for the organism, should be removed from the body, are packed and stored in some other forms. Skin, lungs, liver and kidney plays a role in the elimination of such kinds of substances. Among these organs, kidneys are termed as chief excretory organs as they eliminate most toxic substance, that is nitrogenous compound, ammonia, in the form of urea, uric acid, along with some water and other salts. And kidneys also help in maintaining ionic balance and osmoregulation. Now let us study in detail about human excretory system. Human excretory system consists of a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, one urinary bladder and one urethra. Kidneys are reddish brown bean shaped structures situated in the abdominal cavity attached to dorsal body wall, one on the either side of the backbone. The right kidney is placed slightly lower than the left kidney due to the presence of liver above. Each kidney measures about 10 cm in length, 5 to 6 cm in breadth and 4 cm in thickness. Each kidney is convex on the outer side and concave in the inner side. Inner side of the kidney has a fissure for the entry of renal artery, which carries blood into the kidneys for filtration, and exit of renal vein, which take away blood from kidneys after filtration, and ureter. Ureter passes urine formed in the kidneys to the urinary bladder. Now let's enter into the internal structure of the kidney. The longitudinal section of the kidney shows two distinct regions, outer cortex and inner medulla. These two regions can be identified on the basis of color variation, where outer zone, that is cortex, is dark colored and inner zone, that is medulla, is pale. Medulla is divided into multiple cone shaped masses of tissues called renal pyramids. Each kidney is made up of approximately more than 1 million microscopic and thin tubular structural functional units called nephrons. The nephrons are the structural functional units of the human excretory system. If we observe the structure of nephrons, each nephron has basically two parts. One is Malpighian body and the other one is renal tubule. Malpighian body composed of a network of blood capillaries called glomerulus and a double walled cup called Bowman's capsule. Glomerulus and Bowman's capsule together forms the Malpighian body. The glomerulus was actually formed from the entry of afferent arteriole and exit of efferent arteriole. Afferent arteriole of more diameter carries blood for purification or filtration, which divides into fine branches, which unites again and leaves the glomerulus as efferent arteriole of less diameter. Afferent arteriole having more diameter and efferent arteriole is having less diameter. Because of the narrower outlet, pressure exerts in the glomerulus and acts as a filtration unit. Bowman's capsule is lined by a single layer of squamous epithelial cells called podocyte cells. There are fine pores between the podocyte cells to allow the passage of materials filtered out of glomerulus. The filtration formed in the Malpighian body will be collected into the renal tubule, which has divided into three parts. The first highly coiled portion is called as proximal convoluted tubule, which enters into loop of Henle and which continues as the distal convoluted tubule. Descending limb of loop of Henle is connected with the first portion, that is the proximal convoluted tubule, which passes filtration to the descending limb, which is connected to the distal convoluted tubule via ascending limb. This distal convoluted tubule opens into a collecting tube. This collecting tube forms pyramids and calyces, which opens into the pelvis. Pelvis leads into the ureter. All the parts of this renal tubule, proximal convoluted tubule, loop of Henle, and distal convoluted tubule, are covered by a network of peritubular capillaries formed from afferent arteriole. And this network of peritubular capillaries are called as vasa recta. The urine formed in the kidney will finally enters into ureters, which are slender, whitish tubes which emerge from the pelvis of the kidney. They measures about 30 cm in length. It moves downward and opens into the urinary bladder. The movement of urine in the ureter is through peristalsis, like how we have seen the peristalsis movement in the esophagus while food is moving from the mouth to stomach. Here also the ureter performs peristalsis movement, which is helpful for the movement of urine to the urinary bladder. Urinary bladder is a median storage sac situated in the lower abdominal cavity. It is a pear-shaped structure. Both the ureters opens into urinary bladder. Urinary bladder stores urine. The storage capacity of urinary bladder is 300 to 800 ml. The urine which is stored in the urinary bladder create pressure on the urinary bladder walls, which send signals to the sphincters present the opening of urinary bladder into the urethra. When the sphincters open, urinary bladder releases urine to the urethra. The urethra is a passage for the urine formed in the body to the external. The stored urine will be passed out of the body through the urethra, which is the external opening for excretory system. Opening of urinary bladder into urethra is guarded by two sphincters. Urethra is 4 cm long in females and 20 cm long in male. Its opening is separate in females, but it is common with the reproductive tract in male. Hence, in males, the urethra is also termed as a urinogenital tract. So, this is a brief explanation about the human excretory system. Thank you.